This show is music. It's funky, it's soulful, it's fun.
Fun, energy, and good vibes. I mean, that's a pretty trademark phrase that I've been using.
It's funk.
This show has definitely made me more funky.
It's sophisticated funk.
Well, I was born funky.
This will be the coolest place on television, I'm telling you.
1, 2, 3.
Andre, of course, is a zillion-selling recording artist, a songwriter, a director, a dancer. He had all this spare time that he needed to use up, so he pitched an animated show.
The concept I talked to him about in the very beginning was that I wanted to do a show of a bunch of kids that needed each other but were outcasts in their own right. He took that idea and then he ran with it and said, man, what if we did it kind of like where I grew up in Atlanta? What if we made it all Southern? I said, that's great. I hadn't heard that before.
I wanted to do like a truly original, like Dirty South cartoon. You never get to see those voices. You know, I felt like it was a great backdrop for what I wanted to do.
A lot of it's based on Andre's memories of childhood, but I wanted to have a very magical, whimsical character that kind of led these kids. The Willy Wonka, the Wizard of Oz, the Pied Piper, it has those elements to it.
Y'all need a new music teacher?
Yeah!
So here's the deal. If y'all gonna let me hang out here, you promise to bring the fun, and I'll show you how to put the K on.
K-fun?
Funk. Y'all got a lot to learn, and I just might be the man to teach it to.
Sonny Bridges, voiced by Andre 3000, is a character that was at the top of the music game and then walked away from it because something was missing.
Y'all remind me of me when I was your age.
Looked a lot better.
Lil D is Lil Me. I was telling Tommy this story. I would tell the bus to drop me off like 2 miles away from where I really live, and I would walk home every day, and he was like, oh, that's it. That's the kind of thing Lil D would do. That's a Lil D. Like, growing up, I had all kinds of friends from all kinds of nationalities. I was reading somewhere that Bill Cosby, when he did Fat Albert, most of it, that's his real game, you know. And so I guess sometimes it's best to go off of real people so you have, like, a true connection. Growing up, you had Peanuts. And there was this cool musical element, and so I wanted to create a vehicle where music was really the driving force or the background, you know, to this cartoon. You gotta think, this is a music school, and these are talented kids, so they can damn near play anything. So expect anything.
The style really lends itself to rhythmic movement, and that's a lot about what the show's about and what Andre's about, you know? And musically, it's just gonna make a lot of magic.
The best part about him is that being an artist, he understood the artist's need to be creative and to be let go.
You know, Andre's a very smart guy. In fact, except for hiring me, I think he's made all the right decisions on this show.
I'm
the backup. So if anybody needs like a cut rate, Andre 3000, like an Andre 1500, right here.
You gotta think, Sonny Bridges, he left the entertainment industry. So he has friends, you know, he knows Gwen Stefani. He hangs out with Pharrell, you know, he knows Snoop. So they may stop through the school just to see how he's doing.
Nothing out there looks like this right now. So it's going to blow people away.